In this segment, I will make use of the oracle that we discussed in the previous segment. We will compute the length of the plain text, or more specifically, how many bytes are padded just using the padding oracle. Let me show you how we can do that. This is similar to what we did using the online Cryptey tool. Now I wrote my little Java program that performs essentially the same task, okay, using the padding oracle. The main point to note is that the padding oracle is passed as an argument to the padding oracle attacker, right? That a padding oracle attacker is the guy who's trying to attack the system using the padding oracle as the interface. Okay. And I have this little method called num padded bytes that's going to tell how many bytes are padded in the ciphertext. Okay. Again, recall from the structure of the CBC, from the ciphertext, you cannot exactly tell how many bytes are padded, right? But we will make use of the padding oracle to answer that question. Okay, later we will show how to decrypt even the text if you have access to the padding oracle. Okay, I'm going to start with a simple assumption now first that there is only one block. Okay, so here is your CBC decryption, right? What if we have only one block? So just a ciphertext here, IV here, and this is the only block, and we would like to know how many bytes are padded as part of the plain text. Let me now show to you the code for that. And then I will show you multiple blocks. Okay. Okay, so what we are doing is essentially keep modifying the IV byte by byte. As you can see here, I start a for loop, which will go through all the bytes of the IV, right? And modifies each byte of IV and calls the padding oracle, okay? And if there's a padding error, then we know our modification of IV has resulted in an error, which means that particular byte is part of the padding calculation. Right, again, recall from the picture, what I'm actually doing is as follows. I modify here, and I see whether there's a padding error. If there's no padding error, I continue, I modify here. So let's assume when I modified here, I got a padding error. That means all of these bytes are part of padding analysis, right? That means only the first three bytes of the IV contributes to the, of course, to the first three bytes of the actual plain text. The rest are all padding bytes. Okay, so we can compute how many bytes are padded by just modifying one byte at a time of the IV. That's what I'm doing in my little Java code. So here it is. I'm modifying one byte at a time, right? In the for loop, I take the copy of the IV, modify it by time, XOR it with one. That means something will change. And I check whether my modified IV is giving me a padding error. The modified IV is giving me a padding error. That means that particular corresponding byte of the plain text is part of the padding. Okay, that's what we are doing. And I don't want to modify the user input IV here. That's why I am going to reset. Okay. If there's a padding error, then I go inside and I compute block length minus I. Why is that correct? Let's assume when I modified the second byte of the IV, I got an exception, the padding oracle exception. In that case, my I will be one, right? Because I starts from zero. So block length, let's assume we are working with AES. So it means 16 minus one is 15. So there are 15 bytes that are padded. Okay, you get to know how many bytes are padded using this algorithm. All right, now I'll show you a more general case, what happens if there are multiple blocks? So for that, we will revisit the picture here. If there are multiple blocks, you will be treating your last block as the block that you would like to compute how many bytes are padded over here. We need to find that. For that, we can treat this as the IV. So this block becomes the IV. This is how CBC mode works, it's recursive. So we will treat this block as the IV block. And this is our last block, okay. This is our last block, which means given the ciphertext, the whole thing as input, we just need to extract the last block, this block, and this block becomes the IV. That's what I'm going to show to you now, okay. All we are doing here is we first compute how many blocks are there by computing the ciphertext length divided by block length. And if I compute that number of blocks greater than one, then I know there are multiple blocks. So as I'm shown on the picture, I go to the block that is one block before the last block, and that becomes my IV. And here is my last block extraction, okay? from the ciphertext. And the get block is a little utility that I will show to you now. And then I call the numpadded bytes method that we talked about it just a minute ago. Okay, so let me show you what is there inside the get block method, which basically is just a simple array extraction method. It extracts data from a particular array. Okay, so I'll talk about this now. Here is the get block, which takes the ciphertext, the block length, and the index, and it will just go through this ciphertext array and extract that the block that is specified by the index number. That's it. Okay, so now we have put together the code that will extract the last block and the block before it. And now I'll show you how we can make use of this code to compute the length of the padding. Okay, so for that, I need to show you a main program, which is basically integrating the Oracle and the attacker code. Okay, and the way I put together is that the program will take the plain text as an input. It will create AES key. It will create an IV. And it will call the CBC core method, which we talked about earlier, in the encryption mode. So it will encrypt your plain text. Initialize the padding oracle by passing the key. Of course, the attacker doesn't know the key. And the attacker is only given access to the oracle. Okay. And now the question for the attacker is to compute the number of padded bytes using the IV and challenge text. Both are public anyways. And I explained to you the logic behind number of padded bytes just a moment ago. Okay, and gen key is just a regular AES key generation algorithm. And this is gen IV is just generating the IV. Okay, and now we can run it very quickly, show to you how we are able to compute the length. So in this case, the padding should be of length 13 because I have only 3 bytes. Yeah, as you can see here, there are 13 bytes. And let's do multiple blocks now, ABCD, 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 ABCD. So now the padding must be 16 because the input length is still 16. CBC will add another 16 bytes of padding. So we should get padding length 16. Very good. We got it here. What about if I add another block, say 1, 2, 3, 4? The padding now should be 12, right? You have 12. Okay, so this is how you could make use of the padding oracle to answer your question. In this case, I've shown the simple scenario of finding the number of padded bytes. Okay. In the next segment, I will show to you how to even decrypt the data. That's all. Thank you very much for your attention.